this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to determine limits by multiplying by conjugates. So let's go ahead and get started. Okay, so here we go. So this conjugate business is really going to only happen if we've got a couple things going on. So let me walk you through this. Notice I have a square root symbol here and a constant, or another term, separated by addition or subtraction. If you see these three things, that should let you know that you need to multiply by a conjugate. And you may not know what that necessarily means right now, but that's what we're going to be doing. And the reason is because it actually will help get rid of those square roots. But most importantly, look what I'm approaching. I'm approaching zero. If I replace this with the zero and this with the zero, I get that indeterminate form, which we don't want. So, with that being said, I'm going to go ahead and just get you started as to how to do this multiplication by conjugate. So I'm going to rewrite my first part all over again. And I'm going to get a multiplication sign. Now, I do want to refresh your memory that I'm only going to multiply this fraction by a 1. When I multiply something by 1, it doesn't change anything. But this 1 looks a little weird. Remember that anything divided by itself is always 1. And that's the concept that I'm going to use here. So I'm going to use the conjugate of this numerator. And let me show you what a conjugate is and see if you can figure it out. I'm going to recopy the first term. And then I'm going to do this instead. So everything is the same except for the signs in between my terms. That's all a conjugate is. Now, in order to make this fraction to not affect the integrity of this problem, I have to make this a 1, which means I have to divide this by itself. And now I haven't changed anything. The only thing I've changed is the way that this looks. So at this point in time, we have to multiply. And this is where you got to be really careful. I have two binomials that are being multiplied by each other here. That is foiling or distributing. So very carefully and very slowly we're going to do that. So I'm going to take my first term here and I'm going to distribute him here. Now anytime you have the same expression under a radical, so x plus 1 and x plus 1, and you're multiplying them together, the only thing that happens is the radicals will disappear. And I'm just going to be left with what's under it, x plus 1. This will always be the case as long as what's under the radical is identical. Now, the square root of x plus 1 times 1, well, that's just the square root of x plus 1. Okay, now let's work with the second term, this negative 1. Negative 1 times the square root of x plus 1 is just negative square root of x plus 1. And negative 1 times positive 1 is negative 1. Now, the only thing that's left in my denominator right now, it's a big fraction there, is x times this binomial. So I'm just going to bring this down. And I'm going to see if anything will cancel before I distribute this out. So let's take a look in the numerator and see if anything cancels. So I have a positive 1 and a negative 1. Those are going to go. And I have a positive x plus 1 and a negative x plus 1. Those are going to go too. All I'm left with is x in the numerator. But notice I have an x here and here after everything else is canceled. Those are going to cancel as well. So this actually breaks down to something not so terrible. If everything cancels in the numerator, you are left with a 1 up there, not a 0. Be careful. In the denominator, I am just left with x plus 1 plus 1. So now that I did all my multiply by the conjugate, it's time to plug 0 back in to see if I get something that's a real number. So I'm going to have 1 divided by the square root of 0 plus 1 plus 1. So that's going to yield the square root of 1 plus 1. The square root of 1 is 1 plus 2, plus 1 is 2. So that is going to be my limit. All right, let's do one more. All right, so once again, I'm going to walk you through how to recognize doing the multiplication by conjugate. I have a square root term, I have another term, and they are separated by addition or subtraction. So that tells me I'm going to multiply by the conjugate. So let's go ahead and get this rolling. So I'm going to just copy down my fraction.